In this video, let's use our backdrop tool and we will manually digitize over it. I'll click on backdrop and I'm gonna find a JPEG. It definitely helps if it's a high resolution. All right, so I'll have a little JPEG here. This looks good. And what I wanna do is I'm just tracing over this image using different stitch tools. Now, it's up to you what type of stitch. It makes sense for some sections maybe to be a fill stitch and maybe the thinner leaves to be a satin stitch. It's up to you. Now, it depends on your preference. I am on a Bezier stitch type. That is found in the options. And what the Bezier is, when you click, you will click and drag to create a curve. So it's up to you if you like this stitch type or if you want to, let's show simple draw. In the tools, general options, digitizing, simple draw. Now, simple draw, you're going to use your control key to make a curve. So you'll hold down control or command if you have a Mac, and you can create curves this way. So we're gonna just make some small clicks. The closer they are together, the better. At certain times, you can definitely, go a little bit further. And we'll finish it off. Let's just color it the same color, lime green. All right, now once I've traced each section, if you are using Plus or Lux, you could edit the stitch type if you want. This is a fill stitch. That's what I used to create this shape. And I could use the convert to and make it a satin stitch if I prefer that look. So if you're in Inspire, you would need to start out with the satin stitch if you want it to be that. You don't have the option to convert. So this is what you're doing for the entire design. You're tracing over each section. Now let's say after we create this red leaf here, let's say we need to adjust the location or change the position. In this case, it worked out, but let's say we did the leaf or the petal first and we have to place the leaf behind it. You have these keys here. These are going to be very useful to you. Move to back or move to front. You can see we can move it to front. That wouldn't look great, so we'll keep it how it was before. All right, once you create each shape, you might still need to make a couple edits. I went pretty quickly, so my shapes are a little sloppy. Now, I can curve some of these lines just by clicking on the line, and that way it's not so rigid on this petal. You can also add points if you need, and that will give you a little bezier to adjust the curve. You would also adjust the inclination depending on how you want the stitches to run. And same goes for your satin stitches. If you click your shape tool, you have inclinations, you have split lines. Those are necessary because you can see the stitches run one way and they need to kind of stop and they change direction. So that's your split line. Again, you can move any of these blue points. You can curve your lines and you can add points if you need more to play with. Okay, you can also adjust the density. The density will set to an automatic 0.5. Usually we want to go a little bit lower than that. That way it has a thicker look. Depending on your design and your material, you can adjust density. Okay, so that is how you'll create a file using your stitch tools and manually drawing over a JPEG.